गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट थिंग्स अराउंड अस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, देयर आर अ नंबर ऑफ डिफरेंट थिंग्स अराउंड अस। ट्रीज, काउज, हॉर्सेस, स्पैरोज, क्रोज, इंसेक्ट, पीपल, चेयर्स, टेबल्स, रॉक्स, स्टोन्स, सॉइल, वाटर, एयर, मशरूम्स, एग्स, कार्स, buses, clouds, plastic bottles, televisions are some of the things which we find around us. But which of these things are living and which ones are non-living? How do we separate them as living and non-living? Actually, living things have some common characteristics which make them alive. Non-living things do not have these characteristics. So today we will study those characteristics one by one. The number one characteristic is eating and feeding, or simply we call it nutrition. Dear students, all living things need food for their growth and development. Plants make their own food by the process of photosynthesis. But how do the animals get their food? Animals get their food from plants or other animals. Food gives them energy so that the various processes of life can go inside them. Next, characteristic of living beings is respiration. All living organisms respire. Respiration is the process in which energy is released from food. The released energy is used for carrying out life processes such as growth and movement. Respiration takes place in the bodies of both plants and animals. It is a chemical reaction in which food reacts with oxygen to release energy. Carbon dioxide and water are also produced. The oxygen needed for respiration is inhaled from the air by breathing, and the carbon dioxide produced during reaction is exhaled by breathing. So, breathing is only the exchange of gases, while respiration is the process which releases energy. Different organisms have different organs for breathing. Human beings and animals such as cow, dog and lizard, they breathe through nose and lungs. Birds breathe through air sacs and lungs. Fish breathe through gills. Earthworms breathe through their moist skin. In plants, exchange of gases takes place through tiny pores present in their leaves, whereas insects breathe through tiny openings called spiracles present on their bodies. Next characteristic of living organisms is growth and development. All living things show growth. Growth is an increase in the size of an organism. For example, a baby grows into a child, then a child into a boy or a girl, and then that boy or a girl grows into a man or a woman. Similarly, a seedling grows into a tree. A chicken grows into a cock or a hen. Can we reverse the process of growth from a baby to an adult or of a seedling into a tree? No. Growth in living things is irreversible and permanent. It is internal as it takes place by the addition of new body material. Non-living things generally do not grow. If growth occurs in them, it is due to accumulation of the material they are made up of. It is reversible and external. Next common characteristic of living organisms is excretion. When food and oxygen are used in the body, waste products are produced. These waste products are poisonous if they remain inside the body. They can even kill the organism. To prevent this from happening, the body has a way of getting rid of its harmful waste. And this process of getting rid of waste by the living organism is called excretion. In case of animals, waste are excreted in the form of urine, feces, sweat, and carbon dioxide gas. Whereas in plants, carbon dioxide and water vapor are excreted through small pores present in the leaves. Thank you.